centre to the members' room for them to have a look and have a read look at their leisure. So just before we go in, there's no fire alarm expected for sitting in, but in the event of the fire alarm, please just follow somebody in the wheelchair. This is a public building, so there's no smoking allowed. Anybody who wishes to use the toilets, as you go to the doors there, they just turn to the left and they're just on the right hand side. We do have a request to film the proceedings this afternoon. Is that agreed or any objections? Agreed? Okay. With that, if anybody has any personal confidential information with them, could you please make sure that they are covered and protected against view from anybody seeing that information? And in the event of you leaving the room, could you please make sure that you either cover them over or take them with you when you leave the room? And finally, if anybody does have a mobile phone, if you could put it on silent or switch it off, please. So we do have apologies from Councillor Marianne Welsh, and no other apologies from that. Okay, can we formally open the meeting?
Agreed.
Okay, so is there any declarations of interest for any items that are on the agenda from any members or officers? No? There's no any items to be considered as a matter of urgency, and there's no exempt items for the exclusion of the press and public. Okay, item two is the minutes of the previous meeting. Have they agreed?
Agreed.
Thanks, Chair. Can I actually have them amended, because I actually did attend on that day. Thank you.
Okay, Denise has down as apologies, but we should actually be in attendance if we amend the minutes. Okay, with that amendment to those minutes agreed? Okay, we come to item three, which is the election of the position of chairman.
Thank you, Chair. So could I have nominations for the chair of the authority for this municipal year, please?
Can I nominate Councillor David Massey?
Seconded.
Thank you. Are there any other nominations? Simon? Okay. Do you want to vote? No?
Okay, thank you very much for that, colleagues. Item four is the election of Vice Chair. Can I move Councillor Les Barrow?
I'll second that to you.
Okay. Any other nominations? Okay, can we agree Les Barrow to Vice Chair?
Agree.
Thank you very much. Item five is the membership for the authority for the coming year. That's down as printed, there's no, that's just going on. Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Thank you very much. Item six is the structure for the authority for the coming year. There's no actual changes to the structure. Members should have received the list for the committees and the appointment of chairs for those respective committees, and also the appointments for the ambassador roles and the lead member roles, similar to last year. As regards to the committees for the main chairs, for the policy resources of Councillor Les Barrow, for the community safety and protection is Councillor Dean Stapleton, and for the audit and scrutiny committee is Councillor Jenny Watts. Okay. Agree?
Agree.
Thank you very much. Item 7 is the constitution for the authority. Apart from some slight amendments, is that agreed? Item 8 is the date for the authority meetings for the coming year. Item 9 is the members' allowance payments for the previous year, 2016-17.
Have
they agreed? Item 10 is the scheme of allowances for the coming year. As we have already agreed, the members' allowance scheme will be frozen. So there's likely no actual changes to that. Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Item Item 12 is the appointments announced to the outside body, so the LGA. Similar to mentioned as last year, no changes to that.
Agreed.
Thank you. Item 13 is the standard item for the approvals of conferences and outside meetings.
Agreed.
Thank you very much. Item 14, again, is a standard item for meetings with national politicians and party conferences.
Agreed.
Thank you very much. Item 15 is the proposal for the Merseyside Fire and Rescue Authority. Is there any question on that?
Not a question, Chair, just a few concerns, really. Because obviously there's a couple, it's proposed that a couple of committees are actually joining together, and also that the times and the number of times, particularly that those committees actually meet. I do have concern in respect of the role of scrutiny for the authority, and also because the obviously the decisions are going to be vested with only a much smaller amount of committees. I do have some concerns about the accountability as well for that. So clearly I'm delighted that we would be making a saving if we did that, but I think I've read somewhere that it's the end of austerity. So with that in mind, Chair, if you were minded to take a vote, because, as I say, particularly in respect of the scrutiny element, I do think that scrutiny should be paramount, and probably the more committees that we have, the better, where members can scrutinise. In my own authority, scrutiny committees, a couple of them were merged, and it was a disaster. I'm not saying that will be the same here, but I do have reservations, so if you would be minded to take a vote, I would be voting against.
Just regards the scrutiny element. The Audit and Scrutiny Committee will start this, as it's advertised. The savings overall will be in the region of £20,000. All of, at this point, we're just approving it to all of the consultation. And we'll receive feedback from the District Council leaders, and I'm sure then. Well, we're going to agree to set up a way of party to look at this so that we can give a detailed December. We'll look after all of them on the night of, because there might be various options that have been suggested in the meantime, so we're not saying that that could be the final decision or the final structure of the authority, but we've got obviously change as time goes on. What I would suggest is the way of a party consists of four members, so it'd be three members, so myself, Councillor Barham and Councillor Stapleton have one opposition member.
Well, clearly, I mean, if you're offering me that position, I'd be grateful to take it. I've not spoken to Mary Anderson. I don't think that she'd have a problem with that. But still, my reservations are there, but I hope that wouldn't stop me sitting on the committee to assist you in the consultation.
I think it'd be helpful, because, as I say, we need to look at the detail of how it would look post 2018. So, you know, we need to make sure that we get it right. Because I know that there's various options or discussions going on in different parts of the country. Some are being forced on some authorities, some are doing it
I'm not happy with it as it's printed here, but I'll approach the consultation and the working party with an open mind. And hopefully at the end of that, I'll be more minded to agree it. But at the moment, I think when the proposals are to look at shrinking the number of committees and the number of times that committees meet, on the face of it, as I say, as printed here, I would be minded to vote against it. So I can assure you and the authority that I will approach it with an open mind.
Just on that, where the state's in the report, that's not, that doesn't necessarily have to be another way, it's quite sure. That is a bit of a requirement. One of the things that would have to be looked at, plus the reduction of the members, is that the role of those members would be, would be different from what it is today. So they could be more way involved, and that's one of the reasons that several of the special responsibilities, the discussion of special responsibility at the moment will be articles that we have in the future.
Yes, thank you, Chair. I mean, this report is only a decision to look at making a decision. It's not actually saying that's what the new authority would be like. It's saying we'll have a committee, we'll have a small group of members, we'll frame options and ideas, and we'll bring that back to the authority, because the authority's got to decide. I think one of the discussions that we have with officers is that it would be useful to have a deliberative meeting probably every month. So if an issue came up, you could make a decision so that somewhere along the line there would be a meeting happening that month. And I think also, in a way, if whilst you've got a reduced number of members, that's bowing to the inevitable, really. But if we have more business actually dealt with by the authority, the full authority, the whole range of members, that's one of the options. With you know, a smaller number of committees, it actually increases the engagement of those members who are on the authority, and would enable more scrutiny in that respect. So I think this is, I don't think we've got any choice here. We've got to bow to the way that the whole fire administration is moving in the country. We've got to accept our budgets reduced, we've got to accept the number of firefighters that will be in the future. We've actually got to accept that the job we are doing has increased in importance. We hope has increased in importance. But this report is just about a decision to make a decision. I don't think it's a hostile. It's no, I don't think there's any real problem here.
Thank you, Chair. I'm happy to vote but you know the working committee where you just said that it would be Dave, Wes and Jean, would that be open for other members as well if we wanted to take part in that? Or is it set already through different channels, because obviously everyone would be on it here, so.
What the, I'm sure as I would be, is that we want that working committee, I don't know how many times we'll meet, but we've got a lot of work to do, I'm sure we need a time. Of course, I'll be open to members if they wish to attend, because it's not a closed meeting as such. But it's only because we've all been decided on the 20th, so we'll be able to make a decision that will come back to the authority.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's what it'll be done with. It'll be open to all members if they wish to attend. Okay? Are we happy with that? Can we approve?
Yeah, I would vote against it.
Okay, after she's finished it.
Okay, that's all for that. So with those with recommendations and the amendments that I've suggested, could we go to the vote? So all those in favour, please show.
Chair, members, the purpose of this report is to request that the authority approves the purchase of two aerial appliances under the Vega Asset Refresh Programme. The introduction and the background to the report set out to paragraphs 3 through to 21, which is pages 81 to 83. As it stands, members, the current authority fleet consists of 4 aerial appliances which have an asset life of 20 years. All 4 of the aerial appliances are what are known as combined platform ladders, or CPLs for short. 3 of which have a reach of 28 metres and 1 has a reach of 32 metres, and I'll look at the terms of that point as I speak further to the report. What they're used for primarily, members, is as a water tower. So that's at any significant large incident. So for example, we had the fire recently down on the docks in the MR. We used 2 aerial appliances at that incident, and they're set up as aerial monitors, and they have the capability of a flow rate of around 4,500 litres of water per minute from each aerial monitor, which is 10 times the amount of a single hose line that we can deliver from a fire appliance. So they are a very, very effective tool in dealing with large fires, the likes of which is safe solely on our this in Prescott was another example of sort of fire that we would use them on. They could also be used for rescues from height, rescues from depth, and also for aerial observation platforms as well. So they are multi-use, but it's fair to say clearly you don't get used anything like as much as your standard fire appliances, which is why the asset life is twice as long as a standard fire appliance, which is, so it's 20 years rather than 10 years. Of the 4 appliances that we have, 2 of them are beyond now the 20-year lifespan. So one is 20 years old and the other is 23 years old, so they're not due now for replacement. We've undertaken the procurement exercise using the evaluation criteria, which is set out in the table at paragraph 15, which is on page 82. And the outcomes from that evaluation are set out in the table at paragraph 21, which is on page 83. The cost of the aerial appliances is set out in paragraph 29, which is on page 84. And as members can see from the report, if we were to purchase both appliances at the same time, we would avoid additional costs of £17,400. Note, I'm not saying we'll save that, because we wouldn't, strictly speaking, but we would avoid, if we don't buy them together, it would cost us £17,400 more than if we buy them together. Paragraph 33 on page 85 sets out what we will effectively realise for the part exchange, in which of the 2 existing appliances we part exchange, and that would realise £35,000 for us off the overall cost. Due to the overall expenditure exceeding the limits for delegated authority for myself, we require authority approval to proceed with this purchase. Hence the report and my recommendation that both of the appliances are purchased together in order to avoid the additional cost. I'll pause at that point, Chair, to take any questions that members might have.
Any questions on the
Chair, I'll just offer a little anecdote for the committee which may be of interest to them. There is a parallel piece of work ongoing in relation to what's termed the mass decontamination futures project, and what's that's given rise to a reduction in the number of incident response units which are used for the mass decontamination members of the public in the event of a CBRNE incident. And 2 weeks ago I was contacted, bear in mind this is just after the Manchester incident and just prior to the most recent attack in Westminster in London on London Bridge in Borough Market. I was contacted by Home Office who were, let's say, more than a little concerned that they'd seen on what is, the only way to describe this is the commercial equivalent of WeBuyAnyCar.com, was an incident response unit from a fire rescue service, but should remain nameless, but they were down in the southwest of the country and recently combined. That's Dorset, the world should have recently combined. But there was some concern that they tried to sell their incident response unit complete without any attempt to remove any of the markings off the vehicle, the blue lights and so forth. So it's fair to say that we had to make an intervention there to strongly recommend that that's something that they considered. So some members are aware the part exchange that we're going to subject to your approval. What Angloco will do is effectively strip down the existing appliances, and those parts will be recycled. So the appliances themselves will no longer exist in the form of a combined platform ladder. What I'm saying is, members, that they will be responsibly disposed of. They will not end up on We Buy Any Car or anything of that nature. Just to put your minds at